Rain, where does it come from? Forms of water. The water is available in nature in three forms: solid form, liquid form, gaseous form. Solid form. We call solid form of water as ice. If water is cooled further, we get ice. Liquid form. If ice is kept in open air, due to heat in atmosphere, it will change into water. Water in liquid form is present in oceans, seas, lakes, rivers, and even underground. Gaseous form. Gaseous form of water is water vapor. If water is heated, it turns into water vapor. Forms of water. When ice is heated, it converts into water, and if water is heated, it turns into water vapor. Similarly, when water vapor is cooled, we can get back water. If water is cooled further, we will get ice. So, we understand that these three forms of water are interchangeable. Evaporation and formation of clouds. When we want to dry clothes quickly, we wave them about or keep them under a fan. We have also seen that water on wet roads and some other places dries up after some time, though there is no sunlight. The water in the wet clothes get converted to vapor and mixes with the air. The process of water changing into water vapor is called evaporation. If water is gently heated, it will become warm and some vapor is produced. If it is heated more, it starts boiling. If we heat it further, it evaporates and converts completely into water vapor. If water is heated more, it will evaporate faster. Evaporation is a natural process which takes place on the earth. Water evaporated continuously from the surface of water bodies like seas, oceans, rivers, ponds, etc., and changes into water vapor due to heat supplied by sunlight. The water vapor formed due to the evaporation becomes a part of air. The water vapor which enters into air through the process of evaporation forms clouds in the sky. Condensation. The process of conversion of water vapor into water is called condensation. On cold winter morning, when we speak, smoke-like vapor comes out of our mouths. In winter, the air in our atmosphere is very cool as compared to the air coming out of our mouth. Water vapor present in the air coming out from our mouth gets cooled suddenly to form very tiny droplets. These tiny droplets appear like smoke near our mouth. You might have observed that during mornings in winter, some fog is formed and small dewdrops appear on grass, leaves of plants, etc. Take some water in a glass. Add some pieces of ice to it. Observe for few minutes. You would observe formation of small drops of water on the outer surface of the glass. Ice, cold water in the glass, cools its surface. Air around the glass contains water vapor, which is warmer than the surface of the glass. Due to cold glass, air close to its surface will also become cooler. The water vapor in the air around the surface of the glass turns into water, and forms small drops on the outer surface of the glass. Clouds. On a warm day, the sun heats up the ground as well as the water in seas, oceans, rivers, ponds, etc. This water converts into water vapor by the process of evaporation. The water vapor rises up into the atmosphere. Hence, when water vapor reaches higher levels, it condenses due to contact with cool air and forms small drops or water droplets. These tiny droplets remain floating in air at higher levels of the atmosphere and appear as clouds. Clouds in kitchen. Take a vessel filled with water. Keep it on a stove and heat it slowly. Cover the vessel with a plate. Remove the plate after a couple of minutes. You will find water vapor like a smoke from the bowl heated in the kitchen. Rain. Without clouds, it is not possible to get rains, and that all clouds do not cause rains. Some changes take place in the clouds before they cause rain. The clouds moving in air are generally at higher levels. Sometimes the cool breeze comes along with air, makes the clouds cooler. Cooling of clouds increases the size of their water drops and clouds become heavy and descend towards the earth. The color of such clouds changes from white to gray. When the size of the water drops increase, it becomes difficult for the cloud to hold them and water drops begin to fall. This is called rain. Snow. In very cold conditions, the drops of water turns into crystals of ice and fall as pieces of ice, known as hailstones. Water cycle. During summer, large quantity of water evaporates from seas, lakes, rivers, etc. and converts into water vapor. This goes up into the air to form clouds. There, clouds again cools and produce rain. The circulation of water into water vapor by evaporation, water vapor to clouds and clouds to rain by condensation is known as water cycle. This cycle of evaporation and condensation takes place continuously in nature. Disturbance in water cycle. Deforestation and pollution from factories are causing global warming. So, the atmospheric conditions are not favorable for clouds to get cool. Consequently, there is a decrease in rainfall. This disturbs the water cycle and causes either floods or droughts.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.